How's it going, guys? And thanks for visiting my channel again. Today I brought you guys some C stands with a super heavy boom pose here. Today is not going to be only a review of this stand, but also a tutorial how to properly balance these stands here. So I got all kinds of techniques for you guys here. There's a lot of people that have been doing this for 30 years and I've seen people still doing it wrong for 3 decades. So don't go anywhere. I'm going to be reviewing the GVM C360 C stand with a heavy duty boom pose. Every time you're doing some interview kind of thing or a movie scene, most likely it's gonna be requiring some light on top of the talent here, but safety comes first, and I am a big fan of the heavy duty stuff, especially that I work on larger sets. On Amazon, you see all over the place boom stands like this here. They do fine for holding a 50RS GVM, for example, but any other lights such as a panel and 2x1 panel of anything super heavy, these things are made of aluminum here and they will probably break. Something is gonna break here, and this also is not as stable as something like this here. A lot of people probably still only think that GVM only makes light panels and such, but GVM actually makes everything. They make C-stands, also wireless lavalier mics, and a bunch of other products that I have no idea they made it before. These stands here, they're made of aluminum. They do a good job. This is actually a pretty decently good stand, and this is also made of aluminum here. It has the same concept of this guy's here, but this is gonna be limited to either like holding a shotgun microphone here or like a 1x1 panel, a light one such as the GVM 50RS and similar panels. But when I'm on set, I'm actually required to do larger interviews or larger everything when people hire me to shoot a particular movie scene that they want to do. It usually involves a larger set. So I can't be bringing these little stands here because something's going to happen to them. It's going to definitely break. So every time I go on a set that requires a boom, I don't even bother with these stands here. So I immediately bring this type of things because I know they're going to make me use something heavy there, and this stand is already there. So this stand here is good for both things, light little panels or something as big as a 2x1 panel. However, you have to be very careful with these stands here because this can be extremely heavy. And if you have an assistant or somebody that has no experience, that has never touched a C-stand before or a boom pole of this caliber here, you're gonna be very careful because if you have your finger in the wrong place, once these things are loaded, this thing can weigh over 120 pounds depending what you have loading here, especially if you have the boom maximized to the full extent of the pole. So this particular video here is not gonna be me just reviewing the C-stand. I'm gonna be actually letting you guys know all kinds of techniques that I use here that might be actually useful on your set. And again, the safest way to actually operate these booms here, because these things, they are no joke, especially when they are loaded. And especially when you have people around, either a client or a talent, if this thing falls on somebody, that's not gonna hurt. That probably can actually kill somebody depending what's loaded in here. So I'm gonna be showing you guys everything they wanna know how to operate safely this type of booms here. So I'm pretty sure most of you guys know what a C-stand is. You probably have 10 of these stands on your set here, but there's also the new guys who are watching this video, so this video is going to be actually good for both. The ones that want to learn everything, and the other ones, like you guys, the professionals as well, that wants to probably refine maybe a couple things that I do here that's going to be useful to you guys. So this one here, was actually surprised that it has the same craftsmanship, feels the same, everything here is heavy, and it's supposed to be heavy, and all the knobs here, everything feels the same. This one here is actually thicker. The only advantage that I see, which is small little details, this one here, they actually put a little plastic on top of the actual knob here. Everything is metal here, but they put a plastic here. So for cold days, you're gonna appreciate a little plastic here because it doesn't freeze your hand compared to the knobs that is actually just the bare like this. It's kind of a bit uncomfortable to touch. As far as reach, it's gonna reach right here. This is the maximum reach of this particular boom pole. Now the GVM 360, it does the same exact thing right here. And this is the end of the pole. As you can see, they're the same length. So for the price, I'm actually pretty impressed with this particular C-stand with this boom pole here, because it comes with all the little accessories here. It also comes with this little cable holder to keep everything clean. This one here don't come with that. And my only complaint is that this one here, for example, this particular area here, so when you actually remove that boom pole, that thing is gonna actually sit all the way down here until it reaches the O-ring here. This one here acts like a light would act when you actually hold in the stand. But this is not plastic. This might look like plastic, but this is 100% metal. I don't know if that's steel, but it's at least aluminum. And Again, everything here is got metal, except of course the cable holder, because this should be flexible. The only plastic here is this thing here, which is supposed to be made of plastic. When you actually do your load here, you don't even need to over tighten. When you tighten a little bit, it stays. Same exact way with this one here. So if I close my eyes between the two booms, I will know which one is which, because they both feel very good. And I tell you what, if there's something that they send me here, if I don't like it, I either send it back or I'm gonna tell them, look, it's gonna be probably go on my Facebook page or something like that, but not on YouTube, because I don't wanna be filming all this here. I don't wanna be editing. Stuff takes a long time. So if this stand is actually made to my YouTube channel, it means it's an awesome product, because I would never recommend you guys something that sucks on set. So I actually love this boom, and I also love this boom as well. When you buy this particular C-stand here from GVM, the C360 here at least, it's gonna be coming on a very nice box, because I was expecting this thing to be coming on a bubble wrap with the cardboard. What I found inside, you know, I opened the cardboard and it comes with the laser cut thing, those little foam materials, like soft and rigid at the same time. The legs come separate here. The boom pole is in a separate section. The actual pole here, it comes in another separate thing. All these things here, they can separate. They have to assemble the knob here, so everything comes separate, nothing touches anything. So this whole thing here is pretty impressive, not only the quality of the stand, but also the packaging material that GVM did with this stand here. Every single piece of gear they've seen me review on YouTube here, I actually do this for a living, so I actually take all this equipment to a real world situation, real sets in front of real clients, paid jobs, so I test this equipment on a real set. And I'm gonna be showing you guys here a few techniques how to properly and safely operate this boom pole, because when you actually load these things here, actually, you know what, before you even load these things here, these things can be so dangerous, because if you're talking to somebody, you're distracting, and then somebody does this, this thing comes down and your hand is right here. So a few things can happen. You can actually lose a finger or two here. Or if this thing, if your finger is in the middle here, because these things are heavy and they're made of steel. And again, when you have your clients or especially children or whoever that is around this equipment here, you don't want this to happen, because if this thing falls on somebody's head, that's probably gonna be opening a hole in somebody's head. You can actually kill somebody with this equipment. Now, regarding the legs on the C-stand, obviously you're gonna choose the tallest leg to actually make sure this is actually facing the same direction as the actual main leg right here, which I also highly recommend that you actually use a sandbag. And speaking of which, you gotta make sure this thing does not touch the ground. If it is too long, put something on top here, but you gotta make sure that the actual bags don't touch the ground, otherwise there's no weight on your actual C-stand legs. And again, I cannot stress this enough, these things are heavy, and when this thing comes down, it doesn't matter if this features a spring or if it doesn't, when this thing comes down, if your hands are here, say goodbye to your fingers. So be very careful again and again when you're actually working on C-stands and heavy things like this here. So here I have the GVM S300S, which is a pretty heavy light. So I'm gonna be loading this thing on the boom here. So the first thing you gotta do is to first install the weights here. So put the light down. So before I start anything here, first thing you have to do is to make sure the boom pole is actually facing or aligned with the same tallest leg here. You can actually do it from the bottom here or from here. Then with the stand this way here, gravity is only gonna be pulling down. So you actually install the weights here. The first bag, for example, leave it here. I'm actually gonna be putting the two bags here because I know this light is gonna be requiring two bags. And do not exceed 25 kilograms or 40 pounds or something on these hooks here, because, you know, a hook can actually only hold some weight here, right? Everything else, you can actually use the actual part of the boom pole here to put more weight if you want to. My ceiling here is not 8 feet tall, so I don't know if this light is gonna be actually fitting here. No, it doesn't. So in this way here, you simply tilt this a little bit here, just a little bit, tighten it down, and then you wanna put the light right here. There you go. Now what I have to do is to carefully start untighten this thing here. And it's pretty heavy. And then for the lowest part, that's when you're actually gonna be balancing the thing here. It still wanna fall. There you go. And then you hold here. And then you fine tune the balance. Tighten it down. Now, this whole thing here is completely loose. You can actually operate the boom just like a crane. Because if you put a ton of sandbag weights over here, you're not making your C-stand safe, okay? You still can actually collapse, you can tilt the other side. So even if I wanted to tilt this thing here, where the legs are this way here, nothing is going to happen. But I would strongly advise that you still have this thing aligned with the actual leg there. And then make sure you know what you're doing. Don't get distracted. Don't be on the phone while doing this, because if this thing comes down, somebody touches this thing here, this thing comes down, it's gonna be a big problem. Now, to lift the C-stand fully loaded with as much weight here and this light here, it's gonna be really difficult for you to move because this thing is gonna be all over the place. Just have an assistant holding this side and you holding this side, or you can actually do this by yourself by lifting this way here, and then you move the stand. Do not do that, because it's gonna be extremely wobbly and you will definitely let this thing fall here. So again, this thing is still loose and I can actually control with the pinky. If you put a soft box or anything over there, it's gonna require you to either shrink it down here to compensate, or you have to put more weight on the back over there. As you can see, it's gonna lift up like this. There you go. If you do more, it's gonna fall. But this is actually still okay. It wants to fall, but this is nothing. There's no stress here whatsoever. You can still tighten it down here very lightly, and the light is gonna stay here. It's still safe. But I prefer to balance meticulously this way here. Keep in mind that if you turn the light this way, it's also gonna make the light slightly heavier. But as long as you have a minimum amount of weight wanting to fall or rise, you're fine. Just don't rely on this here to hold the entire stress with the light weight hanging all the way here. Don't count only on this here, because you are going to do this wrong and you're going to have a problem. Now, if you need to make this higher here, when you lift this way, it's extremely heavy. Gotta make sure this is real tight. So the ideal thing is to have an assistant hold one end, the other one, or, you know, but I'm here by myself. Trust me, this thing is no joke, man. You're talking about a lot of weight here. Just have an assistant. One guy holds here, the other one holds there, and no problem. Another way to make this higher, if this is not on the frame, this boom, the arm here, you just do that. And then you align the light, adjust the light here to whatever it makes sense, to light this way or this way here. But if you need to actually rise the stand, again, you need at least two people, so you actually control this part here while the other guy is actually lifting this up. Now, with this setup set here, you actually do not need any sandbag whatsoever, but I would still highly recommend, because if you're working on set, there's people gonna be probably tripping on this thing here, or, you know, but I don't need sandbags because I'm here and nothing's gonna happen to anybody other than hurting the keyboards here and anything like that. But I usually don't use sandbags because I don't need, because the thing is so well balanced and the thing is so heavy, I don't think this stand is going anywhere even without the sandbags. I'm trying to get the stand to move and it doesn't move. But again, make sure you have the sandbags here. Now let's see what happens if you put just a reflector in here. You see that? You gotta simply back this up a little bit here. And it's back to balance. Take this out of here. But again, this is nothing. You can still rely on this here, because this thing is pretty much 90% balanced. Again, if you want to fine tune, you just do that. Perfect again. You put a soft box there, same thing, you know what to do. Now, to collapse the C-stand by yourself, make sure this is fully untightened, like so. You come here and start from this end here. Tighten it down. Now you hold from here, and then you continue to do that. See how safe that is, this method. Then you come here and you undo this here. And my ceiling again is not that tall, so just do this here and grab the light. Hold the stand, and there you go. Put the light down, don't let go of the stand, and then you collapse it this way. So I believe this is the safest way to actually set up your boom pole, especially something this heavy here. And I hope you found this video helpful. I'm here just to show you guys some gear. And if you have any questions, just make sure to drop them down in the comment section. I respond to everything that I see there. And once again, thank you very much for your time. And please consider subscribing to this channel so for more contents like this. And I see you next time.